welcome to this Commonwealth Bank Cup game between Clontarf Beach High and Murgon High here at Lang Park this evening. Fairly important game for both teams. It's obviously a semi-final of some description. We haven't got the full details on that. But obviously the winner from this will go further into the Commonwealth Bank Cup, and maybe they can come through and bring it back for Queensland for the first time. Tonight with me, Redcliffe half Greg Oliphant, and it's good to have you up here with me. Greg, thanks for coming up.
It's great to be here, George. Thanks very much.
Do you know anything about these teams?
No, only that Paul Pye's the coach of Clontarf High, and around the traps I've heard that they're not a bad side, so it probably they might be the side to watch tonight.
There's also been some good players come from the South Bennett area there around Murgon, so maybe the Murgon boys can bring on a good show as well.
There could be a few surprises there, so we'll just have to wait and see.
Okay, after this commercial break, back with the Commonwealth Bank Cup game between Clontarf Beach High and Murgon High.
Ever notice when you shave how the blades get clogged? Well, here's the solution. Push clean blades in the Ultra Pivoting Head Razor from Schick. Just press this bar, rinse, and the twin blades are cleaned.
Ultra's pivoting head, working together with push clean blades, gives you a closer, smoother shave. And push clean blades fit G2 and contour razors.
For an ultra close, ultra clean shave, get Ultra Pivoting Head Razor from Schick. The one with push clean blades.
Prize recipes, fruit cake. The good cakes to eat.
Goodness, you can see that's prize recipe. Goodness, you can see that's prize recipe.
It's all the good things that go into prize recipes, fruit cakes, that make them so good to eat.
Goodness, you can see that's prize recipe.
Prize recipes, fruit cake, the good cake.
For a great family day that won't cost you the earth, visit Bullens African Lion Safari at Beanlea. Once you've bought your all-inclusive safari ticket, there are no extra charges. All the shows, attractions and rides are free. Drive your own car on a 5-kilometre safari amongst lions and other wild animals roaming free. Don't miss feeding time. And there's the fabulous Cockatoo Circus, where these talented performers run through a variety of comical routines. The children will love the ponies and dogs in their mini circus, and Jumbo's Elephant Show is sure to appeal to both young and old. There are rides for everyone too. Camel rides, donkey rides, elephant rides, trampolines, bring a picnic or have a barbecue. Or visit the safari shop for refreshments and curios while the kids enjoy Adventureland and the animal nursery. And don't forget, your safari ticket covers all shows, attractions and rides at Bullens African Lion Safari at Beanlea, halfway between Brisbane and the Gold Coast.
Feeding times are Monday to Friday, 1:30 p.m. Weekends and public holidays, 11:30 a.m. and 2:30 p.m.
Central referee is Mr. Beavers, a famous name for a referee, Greg, for a start.
Yeah, I coached him when he was under 14 at referee.
Is that right?
Yeah, a few years ago.
Jay for what?
Jim.
Jim Beavers, where was that?
That was at Valleys.
He's the centre referee for this Clontarf Beach High, playing Murgon High, and the first kick of the game from... Oh, taken nicely too by the young Murgon lad. As with most of these Commonwealth Bank Cup games, never a great crowd in attendance, but the people that are here are very vocal, Greg.
Yeah, I'm surprised at the following of the Commonwealth Cup. There's quite a few people that are very interested in this football, and I think we're in for an entertaining game.
Murgon with the ball about 2 metres inside the Clontarf territory. Kick for touch. From the 5-8, John Harding, which finds touch about 10 metres from the Clontarf Beach quarterway. First scrum of the match to pack. Halfback for the Clontarf Beach team is Dallas Thrupp. Thrupp to feed the scrum. And I thought that might have incurred a penalty. Yeah. Actually, the big front rower from Clontarf Beach, Alan Bray, did well to kick the ball back in because they'd lost it by that stage, but then they were penalised and lost it anyway.
Yeah, he broke away from the scrum. He wasn't involved in the scrum.
So this puts the Murgon team right on the attack now, only 12 metres out from the Clontarf line. The hooker, Curtis Powell. Oh, and a knock on. The
The young fella had it passed before he got it, Greg.
Yeah, I've heard quite a bit about this Curtis Powell. I believe he left the Redcliffe Juniors. He's playing that other rugby code down in Redcliffe, and I've heard some good reports on him, George.
Having a go at the union, is he?
Yeah, he's lost the last two scrums, so we'll have to follow closely there.
Big front rower from Murgon, Michael Polson, in the dummy half position, and Murgon applying all the pressure in these first few moments. It's the other front rower, Shane Tucker, 10 metres out. Second row coming onto it very strongly is Jeremy Barford. Harding. And once again, the big fella standing out in the back line. They're using Michael Polson to advantage here in these first few moments. Up goes the bomb, and it's well placed too. So wait for this one. Oh, it could be a try. It is. The lock forward, I think it was. Bradley Madden.
It's a well-judged kick, George.
My word. And Murgon go in for the first try. 3 points to nil. Watch this one. He's only 10 metres out. There's a 10-metre line. And he puts it high enough. I thought it was going to come down with some snow on it for a while.
Yeah. It was just lobbed a yard inside from the dead ball line there. And the lock forward was onside. I think it was a lock. It was onside all the way.
Takes it a long time to come down. Plenty of Murgon players there. More Murgon players than Clontarf players. And that was him, okay.
Rotate, yeah.
No, it was the second row forward. We had him slightly mixed up there. Yeah. Alex Morgan was the first try scorer in the game. So Murgon High lead by 3 points to nil after only 4 minutes of play in the first half.
I wouldn't have liked to have been in Greg Thompson's spot in that position, George. Being a fullback, it's one time I'd hate to be a fullback.
He was all on his Pat Malone back there too. All he had was Murgon players converging on him.
I think the best thing he could have done is probably try to knock it over the dead ball line, but
kick's gone
Alex
wide.
Morgan just got in between him and the ball line to score that try.
Kick's gone wide, conversion attempt by Michael Polson. So Murgon away to 3 points to nil lead after only 5 minutes of play in the first half. Paul Souter takes the kickoff. Murgon High just outside their own quarter. Front rower Alan Bray. Good run from the front rower. They're prepared to run onto the ball, Greg.
They're running on it very enthusiastically, George. They're not worried about taking the ball, doing anything fancy at the moment. They're just taking the ball straight up.
Murray Otto put down 10 metres from the halfway line on the final tackle. Shapes the kick, loses the ball. Could be dangerous if they don't pick it up in a hurry, but it looks like Clontarf have got it. And a mistake there from the little halfback from Murgon High, Jack Simpson.
Oh,
and away goes Clontarf, this time streaking down the line, looks for the man inside, and couldn't get the pass to him. The defence puts him in the corner, and this time it's Clontarf's chance to go very close. Good run.
Yeah, it was the captain, Shane Bowering.
Big fellow.
Yeah, big second rower, good strider.
Penalty from the scrum, but it's a differential penalty, so no scoring opportunity with a kick to goal, but nice and handy for the tap free, and maybe points for Clontarf. Terry Eyre, the front row forward, puts into touch, and we'll see what Curtis Powell, the hooker, can do from here. Lock forward Paul Souter looking for a gap there, but couldn't find one. About 13 metres out. Full back up into the fray and jumps into the Murgon defence. Greg Tomlinson trying to get some of his own back from that bomb. Powell this time, the hooker, dummying, trying to get his way through. Murgon have stole it. Quite legitimately taken the tackle, according to referee Beavers. So Murgon Forge now rucking it out. They get to them at 8 metres of the quarterway line. Still about 6 metres inside the quarter. Kick for touch looks good. And it stopped okay, but knocked on obviously by the Clontarf team. Obviously a smattering of young Aboriginal boys in the Murgon team being so close to the Cherbourg area up there, and it's a bit hard to differentiate between them too. Greg, yeah, they all look the same, don't they?
They're going quite well also, George. Yes. Usually you'll find they can do something a little bit different in attack also.
Playing well at present, the big front rower, Terry Eyre. Doing a lot of work. Clontarf steal the ball this time, on the attack. Oh, bad pass. Picked up, but the ball's gone forward. Murgon High leading by 3 points to nil. A try in the fourth minute by second row forward Alex Morgan. And a knock on from the base of the scrum. One of those cardinal sins that halfbacks shouldn't make, Greg, but invariably it happens when you're trying to get up in a hurry, doesn't it?
Yeah, well, that was Curtis Powell's first scrum win, Clontarf's first scrum win, and I think the Paul Pies would like to have kept that ball. Now they're in their attack.
Fullback Tomlinson involving himself in the play. Powell a dummy half. They try the blind side. There's no support. The knockback indicated, so play on for Clontarf. Alan Bray tries the middle of the ruck. The Murgon defence is there right on the quarterway. Murgon leading by 3 points to nil. Strong running from the Clontarf forwards and good backing up as well. They're about 8 metres inside the quarter now. Can Clontarf score from here and draw level? Captain Shane Bowering gets the pass away. They're flying. Oh, they've lost the ball right on the line. And it looks like it's a Murgon ball, or have they got it back? No, Murgon ball. Off the ankle indicated by referee Beavers. Murgon right on their own goal line. Clontarf defence strong, forcing them back. About 8 metres from their own line now. Oh, good stepping run, finds the support inside. Good football from Murgon High once again. If they can get it across that winger, there could be trouble, but good cover from the other side. The Clontarf centre three-quarter coming in to chop the movement off. Oh, no knock-on indicated. And by God, that was a good break from the Murgon team, Greg.
Yeah, George, well, they shaped a kick it there, and I thought that was the right tactic, but I think Clontarf thought the same thing, and they left a gap right down the middle of the ruck, which Murgon found and subsequently made a good break.
Well, golly. Tomlinson up from fullback once again.
He likes coming into the back line. It's good to see George coming in the second line of attack.
Strong runner too.
Yeah.
The hooker Powell from dummy half trying to step his way through, and he is dangerous with the ball, Greg.
Yeah. I think he knows what the dummy half situation is all about.
Should score here. There's men over. Not quite. Rowan Inch. Bowering, the captain, gets it away. Knock on indicated this time. Scrum to pack about 10 metres from the Murgon High line. Murgon High leading by 3 points to nil.
I thought Clontarf could have spun the ball a bit earlier then. Murgon looked a bit skinny out wide, George.
Yes, there was room there, Greg. The young fellow Inch would have done better to try and draw his man and serve his winger, but it's easy enough to say up here, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, that's right.
Murgon just inside their quarter. Once again, it's the front rower, Tucker, working very hard. Jeremy Barford, number 10, just outside the quarter. Kick down centre field this time. Tomlinson's there to cover it. Takes it nicely. Straight ahead. Not afraid to run straight, this young lad. Right on the halfway line.
He runs extremely well. So all the country boys are making, the city boys really earn their yardage.
And the first penalty of the match for either side, being inside the 5 metres in defence, goes against Murgon. Pond after kick for touch. And it does the right thing and finds touch without gaining too much distance. Powell. Bowering's lost it, and Murgon come up with it. And golly, he won't be too happy with himself then. Barford, 12 metres from halfway. Barford to play it back. Still 10 metres from halfway. Murgon Ford seem to combine fairly well, Greg. They get that pass away on most occasions.
Yeah, well, it's surprising for so young guys. They're offloading the ball really well.
Richie Hansen almost got away on that occasion, the Murgon winger. This is the last tackle for Murgon coming up. They decide to run it. Get the ball away. They're going to gain some more ground. Puts the kick in. Good football. But the Clontarf winger's there to take it. And what can he do? Streak upfield, but pull down 20 metres short of the halfway line. Well, surely entertaining, that's for sure.
Yeah, they're playing good open football at present.
Terry Eyre, 15 metres from the halfway line to play it back. Powell to distribute. Chapman, the 5'8". Room to move this time, and he's gone through the split. Oh, it's a good break, but the pass wasn't good. Had it have hit Ron Simpson properly, he may have made more ground there, Greg.
Yeah, the back line drew their men very well then. I thought it was a good back line move. They just need to straighten up a little bit more. Here's the go out wide now.
He'll hang on a bit long, but they still might get through. Powell, a good ball handler. Knock back indicated. No, knock on indicated. I thought he could have been a bit more lenient there, Beavers, but... knock on against the Clontarf captain, Shane Bowering. We've had 15 minutes of play in the first half, and Murgon leading by 3 points to nil. Scrum going Murgon way. Jeremy Barford right on the halfway line. Michael Polson having a big strong run. He's a good footballer, that young lad. He got the pass away beautifully. Halfback Simpson almost to the quarter way. He impresses me, that big fella, number 13, Polson, Greg.
Yes, they're going very well. They're offloading the ball. They're
both the front rowers, this fellow too, Shane Tucker. They're both having good games, the front rowers from Murgon. And look like scoring once again if they can just get the split here. Back inside.
Oh, they've made the break.
Murray Otto, he's a strong running lad, this bloke. On the last tackle, can they score on this last tackle? Brad White is the captain at dummy half, fires it out. They scored off one bomb, we'll try it again, says Simpson, the halfback, but it doesn't go anywhere near the line. Murgon come up with it, and you're offside indicated.
Great piece of play there by Murgon. They had Brisbane in the Clontarf side in sixes and sevens. One thing that impressed me about the Murgon boys, George, the way they offload the ball and run onto the ball. It's quite a good facet of their game.
They aren't afraid to tackle either.
No, they're holding the straight line of defence really well.
Good run from Clontarf on this occasion. Brings the ball just outside the quarterway. Last tackle coming up. Kick for touch on the grandstand side. It's covered beautifully. Ricky Hansen right on the halfway line. Clontarf defending grimly. They seem to have been defending for much longer periods than the Murgon team, Greg.
Yeah, well, they've coughed the ball up a couple of times, George. I think they're trying to do a bit too much with the ball, and they're paying the penalty at the present time.
Penalty going to the Murgon team, and Murgon leading Clontarf by 3 points to nil.
Bite into a crunch. A shattering taste from Nestles.
This is the trigger that starts easier cleaning on all glass and household surfaces. New Highlight. Highlight leaves a sparkle, not a streak. Its special solvents don't streak, don't smear. Use Highlight wherever you want a sparkle. New Highlight leaves a sparkle, not a streak.
It's Charlie Brown and the whole Peanuts gang in another full-length feature cartoon called
Bon Voyage, Charlie Brown!
And don't come back!
Wait until you see what happens to your favorite comic strip characters when they pack up and fly to Europe to spend 2 weeks in France.
Bon Voyage! Charlie Brown, and don't come back.
Commencing soon at the Caloundra Strand, New Farm Village, Southport, Sundale, Toowoomba Strand, Ipswich City Cinema, also at the Anne Lee Chermside, Hawthorne and Gaythorne Theatres.
Penalty kick to be taken now. And it gains good ground. Puts Murgon right on the attack, 10 metres from the Clontarf line. As we said just previously, Murgon leading by 3 points to nil. They scored a try in the fourth minute from a bomb. And looking good at this present moment. Good passing, quick passing, and out to the winger it goes this time. Can they score from here? Nish going for the corner, but pulled down. Nowhere to go this time, big Michael Polson. Chapman inside, playing good football. Shane Tucker, 10 metres from the line. Tucker gets up quickly to play it. Ray Barrett. That's the little nippy halfback Simpson. Just couldn't break through. Last tackle and a scrum to pack.
They're keeping the pressure on Clontarf, George. It's I thought they might have used a kick there, but they elected to stay down in the area and take the scrum.
A couple of injured players receiving a bit of attention here with the magic sponge. Yes, players that have stood out realistically in this first 20 minutes, Greg, with obviously the two front rowers, Tucker and Polson from Murgon High.
Yeah, they've been going very well, and so is it. Bowering and Powell from Clontarf, and I like the halfback from Murgon. He's showed a lot of variation. He's got the kicking, plays a bit of the kicking game. He's turned the ball inside a couple of times, and also the 5'8" from Clontarf.
Yes,
Adam Chapman.
He's not short of confidence, the little halfback from Murgon, are
No, well, you've got to be confident to be a good halfback, don't you?
Scrums are 4-4 at this stage, and the penalties favour Clontarf 3-1. And that's a Murgon ball, so good position for Murgon once again, leading by 3 points to nil. Here's the halfback, Simpson, tries the step. He's stepping a bit into trouble there on occasions.
I think he's moved out to 5'8 at the moment.
Has he?
Yeah.
Giving himself a bit more room. Tucker trying to force his way over, Shane Tucker. Only a metre out. Simpson. And flicked up, they should score from here. Oh, yes. In goes the Murgon centre three-quarter, Roy Barrett. Barrett number three. And he had one man outside him again. So Murgon in for two tries and lead by 6 points to nil. This is a good try. That's Simpson gets the pass away from the dummy half position. This is the hooker and captain, Brad White. He does well to get it away, Greg. He's wrapped up completely. Flicks it out Arthur Beetson style.
Great pass, yeah.
And, of course, once it got out that far, 5-8, Harding just shot it out to Barrett. And he was over. He had young Ricky Hansen in support, but didn't need him.
Did the right thing.
Yes, that was real Arthur Beetson stuff. From Brad White.
Young Brad White, he's playing very well, too. He's in front in the scrums. Or the
5-4.
Even, are they?
He's won that one.
One up. It was a really good ball then.
So Murgon putting it to Clontarf. Two tries in this first half, and there's still 8 minutes of the first half remaining. And we'll see what Simpson can do with this one. A fairly difficult kick. He's got the ball placed at a very unusual angle. It'll be interesting to see how he kicks that. I'd say he'd have to kick with his instep. That's not very often you see a ball placed and kicked like that, Greg.
No, not being a goal kicker,
George. Staying close there, we might be able to see it. I'm sure he'll kick it with the instep. It'll be interesting. Oh, no, he kicked it with his toe.
Oh, yeah.
It's amazing. He's kicked the toe. So, the conversion by Simpson. Shall we say, an unusual type of kick. Yeah, usually when the ball is placed to be kicked with the toe, it's usually in a straight upright position, but not on that occasion, almost an angle of 45 degrees.
Yeah, it's still 2 points, George.
I reckon. I was watching some of the Union on TV the other night, and there's a kicker from England, Dusty Hare, the English rugby union fullback. By golly, has he got a funny type style, but boy, he puts him over with monotonous regularity.
Yeah, well, Ron Giddoo does the same thing for Reece and Summers. I'm sure Bobby Fulton doesn't care.
Doesn't worry too much about it.
No.
8 points to nil with about 7 minutes of play remaining in the first half in this Commonwealth Bank Cup game between Clontarf Beach High and Murgon High. Murgon High leading by 8 points to nil. Penalty from the scrum going to Clontarf Beach, a differential penalty. The Murgon boys with the telecom strike, Greg, couldn't be contacted during the day to tell them to come down a little bit later in the evening. They were due to play about 4 o'clock, not 6 o'clock, so they had an extra couple of hours off school today.
Yeah.
couple of hours in Brisbane to kill.
Pleased about that.
They wouldn't be worried, I don't think.
they're doing their high school proud, George. They're really putting it to the Clontarf boys. We'll see if Clontarf can come back with a try now.
Well, Clontarf have realistically got to come back with a try before half-time to get right back into this game. They're 2 tries down, 8 points to nil against them, but they're doing something about it right now. Alan Braid will play the ball back. A quick pass can do it. The 5-8 saw the gap, but it soon closed on him. Adam Chapman, I beg your pardon. Clontarf going very high, but the Murgon defence is equal to it and puts him into touch.
Very important.
A couple of occasions there. That's twice now that I think Clontarf would have been better served to move the ball. The 5-8 erred on that occasion. He had 4 men outside him, Chapman.
That's where I think the forwards from Murgon should take a bit of a rap, because they're taking the ball up and working it for their backs.
Yes, they are too, Greg.
This is a very important scrum for Clontarf to win. They need a quick hands here.
Murgon's ball. Scrum's favouring Murgon now, 6-4.
He's lost the ball.
And they've lost it. So 5 minutes of play remaining in the first half for Clontarf to put points on. Curtis Powell shoots it inside. The big front rower stretching towards the line. Couldn't make it. Terry Eyre, only metres short. Powell at dummy half. Chapman this time. There's men over again. Gets it away. They should score this time. Comes back inside. Oh, don't tell me he's mustered up. And he has. The Murgon boys have put him down. That was a certain try bomb, Greg.
Yeah, Adam Chapman did good work there. Put a good ball on for the outside centre, but he just couldn't position his winger. He died with it.
Ball away this time. If they keep moving it around, they must score. But the Murgon defence is very tight at this stage. Last tackle. Can they score on the last tackle? There's men over to Byrne. Quick pass, should score it. The big front rower stretches out, and there's the Clontarf try, scored by Alan Bray It was inevitable. Had they moved it across, they should have scored possibly three rucks before that.
Yeah,
they got their try in the end.
All they needed is a quick hands here. They Clontarf seemed to be running too much with the ball. The quick hands is needed, and each player has taken an extra yard subsequently cutting the...
Powell does well. He shoots it straight away. He knew the urgency of the situation. And here's the big front rower, Alan Bray. And he was big enough and strong enough just to force his way. Even though he was attended by two Murgon boys, he was too big and too strong for the boys and puts the ball down for their first points on the board. So Murgon leading by 8-3, and that'll make it interesting for the second half. About 3.5 minutes of play remaining in this first half. And Terry Eyre, his front row partner, looking for extra points from the sideline. That's the quarterway line that you can see in front of him. And as he comes back, you'll see him move over the halfway line. So a fairly difficult kick, no breeze at all. And he's hooked it well away to the left. No conversion by Terry Eyre. So with half time approaching, Murgon leading by 8-3.
It's been a good half of football, George.
Has been, Greg.
Yeah, very entertaining.
One thing about these games, the boys do throw themselves into it with the gay abandon, don't they?
Yeah, they're really showing their enthusiasm here tonight. It's a big night for some of these Murgon boys that probably have only heard about Lang Park, and this is probably the first time they've played on it. It's great to see.
Big kick downfield. He gets a good bounce. It could be good for him, but it's fairly well covered. Murgon back in their own quarter. Winger Ricky Hansen pull down, and that's where Clontarf want to play them. There's the big cheer squad there from Clontarf High. There's no doubt about them. They come in numbers, Greg.
Yeah, they look all right out there too.
Murgon just outside the quarter per medium of Jeremy Barford. By gee, they like to run this ball. This is good football from the Murgon boys. There's no two ways about that.
The forwards are making good gains up the centre field.
Quick passing again. Oh, that was a good solid tackle. Solid tackle and well executed, and a little bit of feeling coming in late in this first half, but quite legitimate. And and there's nothing worse than when you're coming onto a ball like that, concentrating on getting the ball, all of a sudden there's someone right in front of you.
Especially when you don't see him, George.
That's right.
Yeah, he'd come in on the blind side of him then too.
That's right.
Scrum win.
Scrum win to Clontarf. Can they score in this last moment of this first half? If he's got enough speed, he may be able to. Stepping inside. And stepped himself right into a lot of trouble. Yeah. Ron Simpson from Clontarf Beach, number 14. Tomlinson from fullback, ever eager to have a run. Bowering on the halfway line. And half time approaching. Murgon leading by 8-3, 2-1. Alan Bray with the ball, the Clontarf Beach try scorer. Fullback line. Into touch.
Good defence over there, George, by Jack Harding and John Harding and Jack Simpson. They've I noticed in the last try they were the only two to come across and cover defence. It's really good to see.
That's the two halves.
Yeah. Oh, the 5-8 and centre now. Though, sorry.
They have moved around. Yes.
Murray Otto. Wasn't it?
There's the halftime hooter. So at half-time of this Commonwealth Bank Cup game, a very entertaining first half. Murgon leading Clontarf Beach by 8-3. Back after these commercial messages with the second half.
What's new, pussycat? Whoa, whoa, whoa! J&B Records presents the very best of Tom Jones.
It's not unusual to be loved by anyone.
18 monster hits, funny familiar forgotten feelings, Little Green Apples, Delilah. His biggest hit ever.
It's good to touch the green, green grass of home.
Thunderball.
And he strikes like thunder.
An exciting record, Love Me Tonight by Elusive Dreams.
I know your tide follows
Tom Jones at his very best.
My elusive dreams.
Not responsible.
I'm not responsible. Not responsible.
They're all here.
Just help yourself.
The very best of Tom Jones on J&B in record stores everywhere.
The Australian Film and Television School invite applications for the full-time course beginning in 1982. For details, write to the recruitment officer, Australian Film and Television School, Post Office Box 126 North Ryde 2113, New South Wales, or phone Sydney 887 1666.
Hello, I'm John McCoy, and these are this season's 4BC Caltex CX3 car stickers. There's one for each of the 8 Brisbane clubs, which could win you some great cash prizes. They're available now at participating Caltex service stations.
Second half underway here in the Commonwealth Bank Cup game between Murgon High and Clontarf Beach High. The half-time score, Murgon leading Clontarf by 8 points to 3. And looking good most of that first half. Actually, both teams played entertaining football. I thought that Clontarf actually erred on a couple of occasions with not getting the ball away quicker. They could have had more scoring opportunities, Greg.
Yeah, I think you're right there, George. I've got to give their coach, Murgon's coach, Greg Smith, a bit of a rap here. I was impressed the way the Murgon forwards can offload the ball and the way they're moving onto it. I think you know, some of the older blokes, they were watching the game, they could learn something from this also, you know. They're all good ball handlers.
Chip kick pulled in. Penalty going to Clontarf Beach for the Murgon team not facing straight on to play the ball. Once again, the kick finding touch, only just, yes. And not gaining any ground, giving them the tap free.
Interesting to see if Clontarf can hold the ball for 6 tackles, George. They fritted away a bit in the first half.
Yes, Clontarf will be looking for early points. It's just what you're talking about, but that was a knockback, so they retained it, or regained it. 5'8 Chapman. Good dummy, gets the pass away beautifully now. But unfortunately, Clontarf going into touch. Centre three-quarter, Rowan Inch being dragged into touch. 10 metres inside Murgon territory.
He's done some good lead-up work, that Adam Chapman, on a couple of occasions, George.
He's pretty handy with the ball in his hands. Harding is working the scrums for Murgon. The 5'8", you're right, the 5'8" and half have swapped positions. The halfback playing 5'8" and the 5'8" playing halfback. Terry Eyre, the Clontarf Beach front rower, gets the pass away, but they don't gain too much more ground. 10 metres inside Murgon territory. Tomlinson up there again. He's a goer, the fullback.
Yeah,
he's a... Powell, the hooker. He's got a great turn of speed and a good step, the hooker. Could score himself. Oh, great solo effort. And he's ruled him as a double movement and a correct decision.
Yeah, he did the right thing, George. It was a great break, though, by the hooker.
He's got a bit of ability. There's no two ways about that, young Powell.
Yeah.
Could be worth looking at again if we can get it on the video disc, but it was a definite double movement. You're allowed to... He had his momentum. He stopped there. Now he's picked it up again and reached out and put it over. The rule is if your momentum takes you over, had he have bounced over, okay,
yeah,
but
okay,
a deliberate, then definite double movement on that occasion. And Clontarf Beach being penalised for being inside the 10 metres in defence from the tap free. So Murgon get another kick. Mike and Polson.
We'll see if Murgon can come back now. There's a bit of a lapse there in Murgon's defence there. They failed to move up, but they got the ball now, so they'll be putting a bit of pressure on Clontarf.
Bradley Madden, 15 metres inside Clontarf territory. Simpson. Poles and out wide once again. Possesses a good step, the front rower, too. Never fails to make ground, but he's lost the ball on this occasion. And you're tackled, young fellow. The Murgon defence strong, and Adam Chapman feeling the brunt of it from Clontarf on that occasion. About 5 metres from the halfway line, Clontarf. Captain Bowring trying to brush off tacklers. Doesn't allow himself to be pushed into touch, which was good work from Shane Bowring. Powell not getting away on this occasion, the Clontarf hooker. Last tackle coming up. No one to give it to, so Shane Delacour decides I better put it downfield and try and gain some ground. That he does. He finds touch about 20 metres inside the Murgon half. The Clontarf boys have started a lot stronger in this half, Greg.
Yeah, they're putting the game together a bit better now. They're holding the ball, that's the main thing. I thought that Murgon's blind side was a bit suspect there. If someone from like Curtis Powell or from dummy half could have read that play then, they could have shot down the blind side if they had a few runners, but they didn't read it just at the moment.
Powell. Switch. Using the fullback once again as a runner. Murgon leading by 8-3. That was a half-time score. Converted try here from Clontarf could make it very interesting. Bowring, 10 metres out. Powell from dummy half. Chapman. Oh, and they've lost the ball. Try scorer Alan Bray. I thought Bray could have moved it a bit quickly, but he didn't. He decided to hang on and try and crash the defence and lost the ball and paid the penalty. Murgon hooker and captain, Brad White. Warren Fisher having a run, the Murgon right winger. Oh, and he's made the break this time. Floating pass, beautifully done, and a bit of speed coming here, but lovely covering tackle. Good football from both teams. Good football from both teams. Roy Barrett showing the speed, and the cover coming nicely from Chapman from the Clontarf Beach team, Greg.
Yeah, it was a great covering tackle. George, lock that Paul Suter come across very well and covered Jack Simpson. He got a good pass away and to Murray Otto, and he did well to stay infield and keep the ball alive.
Scrum just inside the Clontarf quarter. And Murgon have won this one. Dangerous from here. Not going anywhere this time, Roy Barrett.
Roy Barrett, sorry. It was.
Polson, strong run, over the top, good pass. He impresses me every time he handles the ball, Polson. And Murgon looking good here, leading by 8-3. A try now will make it very interesting for the Murgon team as well. They'll advance further in the Commonwealth Bank Cup. Trying to crash through, 6 metres out. Straight up the middle. Oh, and gets the pass away once again. Good passing. Gets the ball up again, and it's a Murgon try. Oh, no, wait for it. Yes, a try. I thought the defence might have pulled him back. But great work. Second rower scored this one again, Alex Morgan. Watch this passing. We'll take it right from there. Good to watch, Greg.
Yes, it stands back from their forwards. They all got the ability and showing their maturity by offloading the passes here. They're under pressure also, and full marks to Murgon.
I thought it was going to die there.
Yeah, he just popped it up.
Morgan was there. As soon as he stepped inside, I thought, well, he's just got to put it down, but they've actually got off the ground, the fullback, and has done very well, Tomlinson, to try and pull him back. Greg, that was a big effort.
Yeah, he showed plenty of ticker there.
Tomlinson, he's played very well for them. So two tries to Alex Morgan from Murgon High, and the conversion to come, leading by 11 points to 3. This can put them two full converted tries away if Simpson can convert this one. Has the ball laid back once again at an angle of about 45 degrees. Whoa! One up and one down, and the referee says no goal. So it may prove to be a very important kick. 11 points to 3. Clontarf still two converted tries away from regaining the lead. And we've got about 20 minutes of play remaining in this, the second half.
Seemed to swing wide just at the last minute then, George.
Yes, it just shaved the pace. We could see from here that it was out, but the one flag up and one flag down. Had to wait for the referee's decision. Whoop, false alarm. This time. Simpson. You made the comment about the coach, Greg Smith, before. He obviously has done a lot of work with this team.
Yes, the thing that impresses me, the preparation. I think he's done a real good job on the preparation of these boys, and the condition seems to be holding up also for a country side, and which all goes well for Murgon.
Whoa, almost knocked his head off that time. We'll have to have a forward pass. Yeah. Polton once again getting the ball away. And unfortunately, Brad White not expecting it. Hooker Powell to take the tap free. Reversing play. There's room over there if they can move it. Bray comes back inside. Up the middle goes Bowering. Strong run. Can he get the pass away? He's lost it. And it's a knock-on ruled. Clontarf have regained, but their error rate, Clontarf, has let them down badly.
Yeah, well, there's still plenty of time for Murgon to get back into this game, and they've been doing the same thing all night, is dropping the ball, and I think they need a steadying influence there somewhere to steady the game down a bit. I think they could go a lot better, but there's still plenty of time in this game for Clontarf to pull it out of the bag.
And that's the prize that all the teams are playing for, the Commonwealth Bank Cup. Let's hope that one of the Queensland teams that get through to the semi-finals can be at Leichhardt Oval on grand final night, Greg.
Yeah, it'd be great to see, George. It'd be a feather in Queensland's cap. And
I'll tell you what, if the Murgon boys get there, they'll give them their money's worth.
Yeah, they sure will. And I reckon the whole Murgon would probably trip down there to see that, I reckon.
Here's the Murgon cheer squad, if you can find them.
I just noticed there's number 16 warming up down here, George, for Clontarf. It's Brett Hayward.
Hayward warming up. There's the Murgon cheer squad. They've obviously got on the bus this afternoon and come down as well, and they've surely done their work.
Yeah, they're earning their money tonight. This Brett Hayward, I believe he's the brother of John Hayward that played for Western Sydney.
Is that
family
right?
Moved up here to Queensland, and
and he's going to get his chance by the look of it. He's warming up down there. Clontarf need the try. Down by 11 points to 3. Still plenty of time remaining. About 17 minutes of play remaining in the game. The pass goes out. There's plenty of cover there from Murgon. But inside comes Mark Dimmick. Dimmick 11 metres from the line. Shane Bowering. Finally put on the ground. He'll score himself. Murgon boys looking, and there's a blue one in background. And it's not a bad one either, by golly. They're not afraid to throw a few in. They're still going. Whoop. Oh,
I tell you what, she's lasting a fair while, Greg. It's one of the longest ones I've seen for a while. And there's going to be some sore heads in the morning.
Yeah, it's not a real good spectacle for rugby league, though, George.
Particularly in the schoolboy status.
Yeah, the referee, Greg Beavers, rewarding the try then to Alan Bray.
Here's the start of the try. There was the little flare up there where you just see him. And the Murgon team just stood right off. And he thought, well, if that's the case, I'll just keep running. And over I go for try number two.
Yeah, well, he did the right thing. He played football and he got 3 points and possibly five. Because Alan Bray, it was a great break from him.
Second try to Alan Bray, the Clontarf skipper, and the number four for Murgon High is Murray Otto being spoken to. So what's he going to rule now? Obviously he's got to rule the try.
He sent Murray Otto off the field for 5 minutes by the look of it, George.
Right. Well, we've had a bit of everything.
Yeah.
That was, they probably, the game really flared into a bad spectacle. There's no two ways about it.
Well, the game had plenty of excitement, but that sort of just added the cream to the cake, didn't it? it was a great try from Alan Bray. He came down the blind side, and as I said before, I thought Murgon were a bit skinny on the blind, and I thought, you know, if Curtis Powell could have taken off there and then we had some runners from Clontarf, they could have come up with a try a bit earlier, but full marks to Alan Bray for a great try.
That's put Clontarf right back in the game, 11-6. And if he can kick this one, less than a converted try away.
Plus, Murgon have only got 12 men, George. So.
For the time being. Did he indicate five, Greg?
Well, he put his hand up. It looked to me
good.
To be five.
No, just wide. Just wide. So, still nothing in it. Only a converted try out. 11 points to 6. With about 15 minutes of play remaining in this pretty spirited Commonwealth Bank Cup game between Clontarf High and Murgon High. Murgon High have scored 3 tries to 2 and lead by 11 points to 6. We'll see if they can settle down and play a bit of football now. Lock forward from Clontarf, Paul Souter. Haywood's on there, number 16, and both 9 and 10 are on the sideline, so there's obviously 2 replacements on there, Greg.
Yes, George, interesting to see how this Brett Haywood goes. Not that he'd like to live in his brother's shadow, but if he's half as good as his brother, he'd be a good player. Johnny Haywood had several seasons in Sydney and now I'm playing in New South Wales country.
Murgon back on the attack. Hooker White. Oh, good pass.
Good pass
once again. But Murgon have lost the ball this time. Quick to do the tackling. Shane Tucker trying to cover his mistake.
It's at fullback Greg Tomlinson again. He's not frightened to come forward and take the ball up a few times when he's tired.
I think he must have been a second row forward come forward,
yeah.
Greg.
Yeah.
There he is again.
It's well done too. He gives his forwards a bit of a break.
Kick through and here's danger. A race for the ball, Clontarf and Murgon, and kick safely in the touch by Clontarf.
Clontarf are putting unnecessary pressure on themselves through bad passing and they seem to be paying the penalty all night for this.
Ooh, bit of a soccer player too, Paulson.
one of the rare occasions that Poulton's run with the ball, he hasn't unloaded it.
Yeah. Well, that was, he did the right thing then, George. I thought he just had to settle the ball up, and they can set their attacks up now from, and they're sure he can play the ball. Here he goes again. He's certainly in the fray.
Oh, good pass too. Murgon looking very dangerous once again, knowing full well a try now can almost seal the match for him. And oh, there it is. Shane Tucker goes in for Murgon. 14 points to 6. And as we said previous in this replay, in this broadcast, both the front rowers, there's Tucker with the ball now, both possess a good step and both have a great pair of hands. And if they keep playing that kind of football, they're in for a big future. There's no two ways about that.
Yeah, well, that's the difference between the two teams is the forwards of Murgon. They've done extremely well.
So 4 tries to 2. And 14 points to 6 with the kick to come from young Jack Simpson.
See if you can stay close on that ball, will you, Graham, when he kicks it?
There's the unusual slant. That gives you a better picture. There's not very often you see a ball placed like that for someone to kick it with the toe. And if we stay in close there, we'll probably see how he does. There it is, a nice close-up of it. And he comes now. And it's definitely a toe kick, Greg.
Yeah.
And he's not real bad at it either.
He's got a bit of direction, though, hasn't he?
Converted that one, 16 points to 6. And I think that's basically put it beyond Clontarf. But with 10 minutes of play remaining, one never knows. Did I see Otto come back onto the field?
That's right, that's correct, George.
All right. So he's done his 5 minutes in the sin bin. A couple of big lads in those teams, both Poles and Tucker, Bray and Eyre. The four front rowers are both big boys, and so is Bowering, the number 10.
They're hitting nice and hard too in the forwards, in the defence.
He must have just been having a spell, Bowering, because he was definitely sitting on the benches out here. I said both 9 and 10 sitting in the benches, and so he's put the chip kick through and got it. Oh, lovely stuff. That's typical. 5 tries, and Simpson goes in to make it 19 points to 6.
Great piece of work then, George.
Let's have a look at it right from when he's put the ball up in the air. The one has to be slightly lucky on that occasion, but fortune favours the brave, as you know. Here it is, going up. He hasn't taken his eyes off the ball all the way, Simpson. Down it comes, bounces high. He just gets his fingertips through it, enough to propel it forward enough to come back into his arms. Steps away from young Tomlinson, and then he's got a clear path to the line. And won't the people from Murgon hear about this tomorrow?
Yeah. Well, it was a good decision by the referee, Jim Beavers. Also, he could have ruled a knock on then, but he was on the spot, and he judged it that it wasn't a deliberate knock forward. Therefore, Jack Simpson scored the try. It's a bit of a hard position for Greg Tomlinson to be in. He sort of had to worry about the ball and also the attacking player. He didn't know quite which one to take at the time.
Okay. So Simpson attempting to convert his own try. 5 tries now to Murgon, 19 points to 6 with a kick to come. And if the issue was in the balance before, it's beyond doubt now, Greg.
Yeah, he's played well, though.
He hits it.
Jack Simpson.
Up and over.
Played most of the game at 5-8, but
21 points to 6 with about 8 minutes of play remaining in the game.
Everybody's celebrating Smith's Crisp's golden anniversary. 5 Holden Geminis to be won. 20 Savage Kingfisher runabouts with Johnson outboard motors. 100 National Panasonic FM-AM portables. Over $50,000 in prizes. Answer this question, send your entries to this address with 3 50th anniversary symbols or facsimiles from any Smith's Crisps packs. Enter now.
For 15 years now, you've been reading about Australia's best-loved world tour, endorsed by Australia's best-known magazine, the Women's Weekly World Discovery Tour. You've read about other people having the time of their lives, seeing all those places you've always longed to visit. Like the places we're going to on our 1981 World Discovery Tour. First, you fly to Singapore for a stopover and on to Athens for a Greek island cruise. Next, to London to start your grand tour of Europe, showing you France, the splendor of Italy, Yugoslavia, Austria and Switzerland. A Rhine cruise through Germany and on to Holland. But that's not all. How about a tour of England and Scotland? Finally, you board the Ariana for your cruise home via the Caribbean, America and the Pacific. It's all here in the 1981 Women's Weekly World Discovery Tour brochure. Don't you think it's your turn to go? See your travel agent or World Travel Headquarters.
Strong pain can strike at any time. Solpadeine is an effervescent answer to strong pain. Solpadeine is the first soluble pain reliever that combines gentle-to-the-stomach paracetamol with the proven effectiveness of codeine. Naturally, use only as directed and see your doctor if pain persists. Solpadeine, an effervescent answer to strong pain. Available only from your chemist.
There he is.
Put his game together well tonight.
He has, yes. He moved to 5-8 fairly early in the game.
Yeah. He's varied the play well, and he defends well too. It sounds like the whole town of Murgon's here, George.
I wonder if our sound effects mic can pick that up. It looks like there wouldn't be any more than, I'm not being nasty, there wouldn't be any more than 100 people in that grandstand. But you'd reckon there was 10,000 over there, the noise they're making for Murgon.
That's right. The supporters are just as enthusiastic as their players, and so it's great to see also.
Away they go again. Oh, nicely shot out that one. But the 5-8 playing halfback Harding allows himself to go into touch. They might even get a day off school tomorrow, these blokes.
Yeah, they could do too. They deserve it. But it all goes well for Murgon when they go on further in the cup. With this pack of forwards they've got, you need the forwards to win the game, George. And with this pack of forwards, the way they play tonight, they could shake a few of the teams in Sydney.
Yes, they're fairly well balanced, Greg. The hooker is Brad White. He's a fairly big lad for a hooker, but when you put him beside the two props, Tucker and Polson, he then becomes reasonably small. I'd say most of those young lads would be tipping the scales at least 12 and a half, nearly probably 13 stand.
Yeah, I'd like to stand beside some of them. But, Alex Morgan, the second row also, he's a good runner. He runs on the ball well, and he's defended well tonight also.
But attention being given to Polson, the front rower, and it would be difficult to pick the best player out of the Murgon team, but I think my vote would go to the young fellow receiving the attention now, although they've all played very well. Actually, the Clontarf Beach team have played very well, but they've just let their error rate become too big.
Yeah, they made too few many errors, especially in the handling department, to get any continuity and attack going, and they've paid the price. That's where they've paid the price for sure. See if they can come back and score a try from here.
Unloading the ball well. Alan Bray, who scored both their tries with the ball then. Oh, and that's typical of what's been happening to the Clontarf Beach side. They've been trying things. It just hasn't been coming off. And every time, Murgon's capitalised on it. And if anybody's tried to try and turn the tide, it's been the fullback, Tomlinson. He's been in everything.
Yeah.
There he is in there again. I think he has moved to the forwards.
Yeah, he's probably sent one of the forwards back to look after the
shop.
Said, look,
you get back there for a while and give me a go at him. Here he is, a dummy half. 4 minutes of play remaining in the game. And Murgon High leading by 21 points to 6. They scored
it's a good pass from
five them. Tries to two. Yes, it is good passing. And a determined run down the touchline. Not into touch. Clontarf trying to finish on a high note. Bowering, the captain, charging towards the quarterway on the last tackle. Will they put it up or not? Coming back. No, they're going to spring it along the line to nobody. And that's, as we said, one of the problems with the Clontarf play is they just allowed too many errors. Tomlinson from fullback. And if anybody should score a try, this young lad should. Five metres out now. Mark Dimmick to play the ball back. Alan Bray, who's scored both of their tries for Clontarf. Quick passing can score a try here. If they get rid of it in a hurry, they do. But the pass is wide. And another scoring opportunity gone begging. But we'll play the ball right here just inside the quarter, says the referee. Last tackle coming up. Picked up on the half volley, Bowering. They should score, but once again Murgon's defence is equal to the task, and a knock-on result.
Yeah, well, that was good work from Adam Chapman there, but the Murgon defence was equal to the task. When they've had to, they've tackled well also. They've had good attack, but they can back it up with good hard-hitting defence, and it's good to see. And you can only wish them all the best in the future in this Commonwealth Cup.
Looks like Greg Smith, the coach, is going to replace four players in the last 2 minutes and let everybody put their boots on the Lang Park turf whilst they're here. Penalty going to Clontarf from the scrum. A quick tap. They want to hurry and get on there, or they won't get a chance to get on Lang Park. Chapman stretching towards the line. He's over. Determined try. Determined try from Adam Chapman. Clontarf's third. And it's good to see them not giving up. This is a good run here. That's the 10-metre line.
Great piece of work. He's got a
he's using the ball in both hands all the way, Greg. Oh, Murray Otto let him go badly. Both those players should have pulled him down, Harding and Barrett. But he decides that he wants to score now. I'm close enough to that line, so I'm going to score, he says. And that he does.
It was a bad
over.
Bad defence from Murgon. There were seven guys went to tackle him, and it was good work from Adam Chapman. It showed he really wanted to score that try bad, and makes the score look a bit more respectable.
Yes, 21 points to 11 is a lot more respectable than 21 points to 9. And the four replacements from Murgon High have got on the field and jump into the fray for the last 60 seconds. So into touch they go.
They're probably getting a bit tired now, George. The game's been played at a cracking pace, hasn't
it? It has. It really has. Once again, away goes Clontarf. There's Tomlinson, the fullback.
Oh,
back to Chapman.
Pass.
And I tell you what, two tries in the last minute. That's not good defence from Murgon. But good attack from Clontarf. They haven't given in. They've played it right through to the end. 21 points to 14 and 5 tries to 4. Looks better than 5 tries to 2.
Yeah, well, they showed Clontarf showed a lot of heart. Great try.
Tomlinson, their best player, I think, the fullback.
Yeah. Right from the first hooter, he's really got himself involved in the game. Adam Chapman, not far behind him, backed up well there after making the initial break. And I think if it was only for the mistakes of Clontarf, maybe a bit earlier, but could have brought him undone. But 4 marks to Murgon, who stuck to their guns right throughout. Their forwards have played extremely well, backed up by some snappy work from their halves in John Harding and Jack Simpson, and Roy Barrett also in the back line. He's played well.
So Terry Eyre to try and convert this this last try by Clontarf to make the score 21-16. And there it is. So the full-time score in the Commonwealth Bank Cup from Lang Park tonight, with Murgon High running out winners over Clontarf High by 21 points to 16. Back after these commercials to talk to Greg Oliphant about the game.
The world's best, banded together into rock and roll's finest, the rock album. Whatever you want, whatever you like, whatever you power, say, track to track with rock's finest performers. I don't like reggae, yeah. Dire Straits, Graham Parker, Fleetwood Mac. The Rock Album. Hot-blooded, check it and see. I'm hot-blooded. The Rock Album, a killer cut after cut from KTel.
Available from these retail outlets.
The big strip is about to begin. The bigger Ripper Stripper in the 500-gram aerosol can is here. Ripper Stripper, the multi-purpose stripper, removes paint from easy and hard to get at places. Just apply, wait the desired time, and scrape or wash away. See how easy this outdoor furniture cleans with Ripper Stripper. Remove grease from engine parts and garage floors. Ripper Stripper, the multi-purpose stripper. Look for it in your store now.
Now at Price Right Hardware, Kmart, David Jones, Brightway, Stewart's Auto Mats and Mad Barry's. The annual Villanova College Art Festival is on again this weekend with hundreds of original paintings for sale and a fabulous display of arts and crafts. Don't miss out. This Saturday and Sunday, June 20th and 21st, Villanova College, 6th Avenue, Cooper.
Well, there it was, a very interesting and entertaining Commonwealth Bank Cup game between Clontarf High and Murgon High. Murgon High running out pretty convincing winners, really. 5 tries to 4, 21 points to 16, actually flattered Clontarf Beach slightly. The try scorers for Murgon, Barrett a try, Simpson a try, Alex Morgan 2 tries, and Shane Tucker a try, and Simpson kicking 3 goals. For the Clontarf Beach team, front row Alan Bray 2 tries, and the 5'8 Adam Chapman 2 tries, and Terry Eyre kicked a couple of goals. The scrums were 9 apiece, and the penalties favoured Clontarf by 9-4. Greg, an entertaining game.
Oh, I thought it was a great game, George. It was played at a cracking pace, and I thought Murgon showed plenty of ball skills in their forwards, and also we saw some good running by Clontarf forwards also, and also Greg Tomlinson coming from fullback there. He did his job quite admirably, but I think all around Murgon forwards were just a bit too strong from Clontarf on the night.
And your best players?
My best player is pretty hard to pick out, but you know, Michael Paulson, I thought he had a great game for Murgon, and also their hooker and captain Brad White with Jack Simpson, the 5'8". I thought he showed plenty of potential there, and plenty of flair and attack. And Greg Tomlinson for Clontarf, and maybe Curtis Powell and Alan Bray played well for Clontarf. So, you know, all around, it was a great game. You know, there's a lot of good players in the both sides, and but as I said, I think Murgon capitalised with their forward strength.
OK, well, there it was. Greg Oliphant summing up the Commonwealth Bank Cup game here from Lang Park tonight. And we wish the Murgon team all the best in their endeavours to get the Commonwealth Bank Cup up here in Queensland. Final score once again, Murgon High 21, Clontarf Beach 16.